We've just seen there the Knipex Step Cut, and it suggests it saves you 40%, and we like that at eFIXX.
Yeah, that's 40% effort, Gary, not necessarily time.
So it's not going to make it faster, it's going to make it easier for us. And we've been practicing these off camera, and I damaged my wrist as a younger man, before you jump in there with any comments, and that was playing golf. And we found off camera, didn't we, that I really struggled with a set of side cutters in order to cut the cables that we use the step cutter for. So should we take a closer look at this step cutter?
Yeah, let's have a little look, just see the difference between a regular pair of side cutters. So there's some, obviously, side cutter, straight blade, but then we will look at the step cutter. It's got this serrated blade here, which is the key to that 40% effort reduction. Now, it was designed to work on what's termed NYM cable across in Germany. So this is a common installation cable, which we don't use over here. So we'll try it out on this, but then we'll check it out on the cables that we use.
Okay.
So I'll just open up our step cutter.
So that step in action then means that we're going to cut through the conductors, not all at the same time. We're going to cut through them as we go, and that's where you get the step from?
Yeah, and you'll hear it as it goes. So I'm just going to start now. So you'll...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you can hear it in cutting the individual cores. So that was easy. Now, just for... obviously, fairness, I'll try it with a pair of side cutters.
All right, okay. Maybe we'll watch from a distance here because we can watch some effort going on here. Yeah? How's it going?
Is it good? I think I'll have to cut them sequentially, but munch through them in order. There we go, and there's a bit of ricocheting cable going across the workshop there.
The effort in the wrist, though, is completely different, is it? They're saying 40%, but that went through effortlessly with the step cut, but obviously, side cut is
done. But importantly, look at what it's done to the cable.
So, a little look.
So it's now not a round cable anymore, it's a sort of squashed cable. So yeah, you'd have to adjust that if you're then going to put this through some sort of cable gland or something like that.
But, and the step cut is designed for copper and aluminium conductors, and don't go anywhere near a steel wire armoured cable.
No, I'm not suggesting, I wouldn't suggest trying to cut steel wire armoured.
And it does look like we've got some steel wire armoured cable down here, but we've actually got the equivalent that we're going to try and cut that we'd have in the UK when we won't be having this type of cable, which we see on the continent.
Yeah, so not NYM, we don't use that, so let's try it on some cables that we have in the workshop. So here's some...
What is it?
I always get this wrong. Is this the tough sheath?
It is, it's
not the high tough, but in Europe would be known as NYY, or certain wholesalers sell it as that, but we use this a lot.
What are you going in with first?
Well, just sort of step cut, so watch this. Okay. Oh.
Let's just, can I have a look at the end once you cut the next one? Cut one more. Okay, yeah.
Okay, kept a round end.
Because it can go up to, is it 4mm², 5 conductors, isn't it? And that's what we looked at previously, so that's obviously well within its limits.
Yeah, so again, I'll try the cutters on this. Just so, again, it's not difficult to cut the side cutters, but again, look at what's done to the shape of the cable.
Okay, yeah, squashed it.
But, so, okay, yeah, right, Gary, go up to 4mm, so I couldn't find any 5 core. But what I could found is this EV Ultra cable, which is 3x4mm conductors plus a data cable in there.
Oh, right, okay, so we're looking at about the maximum diameter being 15mm that it can work with this step cut. So we're about there at that,
we're about there with this, so let's just try with the step cut. So again, you have to open the jaws fully to get this in.
Wow.
That was, I make that look easy, don't I?
You do.
Yeah, so.
That's just on its home turf, though, isn't it?
Yeah, so just a short chain. Back with the side cutters again. Okay, so I'm going for both hands. Yeah, I'm not going to do it in a one. I'm not going to do it in two. Yeah, and again, we've...
Look out there, ricochet.
Ricocheted, and yeah, I mean, look.
Squashed.
What a mess.
Yeah, what a mess. Now, we're not suggesting that a normal set of, say, croppers wouldn't do this, but it's the step in action we want to get over to you. By not cutting all at the same time, it obviously makes it considerably easier. And I think we could hear and see the effort was less with the step cut, wasn't it?
I could see the effort.
Yeah, first time in a long time we've seen any effort from Gordon. Now, it's probably going to be used also on cables like this, especially on the continent, up to, they say, 50mm² on this fine stranded as
well. Yeah, so this is it's like a tri-rated cable. So again, it's just...
There we go. Well, I'm going to bring the camera in because that is easy. What size is that? Is that 16mm²?
It's a 16mm, yeah. Class 5 conductor.
Okay. The likelihood is once we've cut that end, we're probably going to put a ferrule on it, aren't we?
Yeah, which obviously, if you're going to put a ferrule on it, you do want it to stay...
Round.
So again, in with our regular side cutters, and again, it's more effort, and I've now got a sort of flattened conductor, which, if it was going to be ferruled, you would now happen to be...
A little bit more trouble there.
Adjusting that back to where it should be.
Okay, we've got the chrome plated version.
Yeah,
we have, haven't we? And they do other versions as well, don't they?
Yes, but yeah, I guess the one for Europe is this VDE tested to 1,000 volts, and it obviously matches the other ones in your Knipex tool bag. If that's,
and they're similar size to a set of side cutters. They're 160mm long, aren't they?
Yeah, for compact. Now, what was the last one Knipex asked us to try it, or we suggested we'd like to try it on some meter tails, and we've been recently having some work done, so we thought we'd pass it over to our TAME electrician to see what he thought of them on some meter tails.
So let's see how Eddie's going to get on with this Knipex step cut then. He's already done two, so he's a little play around with it to start with. He's got one more line conductor here to have a go at. Let's see how easy it is to cut then, Gordon.
He's got the power gloves on.
Yeah, here we go.
Does that make it 40% easier as well?
Well, that did look easier though, didn't it?
It did. That was easy.
I think he's going to use it now in a little novel approach. I think he's going to remove PVC for terminating purposes now.
Or use testing it as a cable stripper as well.
Yeah, a ringing tool here of some sort. I want to get through to conductors. So try not to damage the copper. I think he's done that okay. He's happy with the length. Oh, what now? He's going to go for one layer of PVC now, is he?
Okay.
A bit of fine adjustment here.
Calibrated hands, especially with those gloves on as well.
See how he popped that off? That was beautiful, wasn't it? Just popped it out of the way. So he's in and ready to terminate then. His feedback was, wasn't it, that he got used to it after he'd done a couple of three of them when it was opening them up, wasn't it, that was the issue initially.
Yeah, but I think you can say we can cut meter tails with those quite easily.
Yeah, without any effort. Massive thanks to Eddie from Pegasus Electrical for doing a little field test for us there. And he said it was easy for them to use. It was just that opening up that was a little bit tricky, wasn't it?
Yeah, it is. Because when you're obviously going for larger diameter cables, you do have to, obviously the tool there is fully opened out to get around the cable. But then again, once you're in it.
That step motion.
Yeah, dead easy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's what he said, didn't he? He took a couple of attempts and then once he got used to it, it was like, okay.
A lovely, nice clean cut. Now, obviously, well, I might as well, just since we've been doing this throughout this video, I might as well try with the side cutters.
Let's watch.
Yeah, so let's just...
My wrist wouldn't do this.
Oh, dear me.
Yeah, how's it going?
Not very well.
I'll probably do it a little bit at a time, maybe. When you couldn't find your croppers, that's probably what you did, didn't you? A little bit at a time. How's the effort going?
Yeah, it's a lot of effort. I'm not getting very far. Oh, there we go, we're getting there. I've just destroyed everything off the bench. Yeah, so if you look at... let's just compare the two ends then, Gary. So you've...
let's have a little look.
So yeah, I've sort of...
yeah, mine are nice, aren't they?
Yeah, that's a bit messy and did take a lot of effort.
Did it?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know whether anyone noticed.
Yeah, you wouldn't be doing that all day. You would, repetitive strain injury. Well, I don't know. You used to get that on the golf course, Gary. We've heard about it.
Yeah. But you spotted there, and I have got a weakened left wrist. That's not a joke. And that was easy. I punched through those. Not a problem at all. Mm. So the step cutter, or step cut, I keep adding that on, the step cut makes life easier because it's not going to cut it all at the same time, it's going to do it in stages. But as always, we want your feedback. Are you currently using this tool and you think it's excellent? Is there something we haven't mentioned that you've got as a top tip and you want to add it to the comments below? Were you thinking of buying the Knipex step cut in the future and you've watched this video and maybe that's something you're going to do? We get back to as many of those comments along with Knipex as we can, so leave them below.